Sex and happiness both enrich our lives, yet it's surprising how few people can honestly say that they enjoy regular and fulfilling sex or describe themselves and their lives as happy. Host Lori Handlers helps you to experience real intimacy and happiness. You'll laugh a little, learn a little, and we hope put a smile on your face and a smile in your life. Now here's Lori.
Hi, everybody. This is Lori Handlers, and you're listening to another episode of Sex and Happiness, a show about your sex and your happiness. And today I have a very special show. I have a guest whose name is Dr. Sandra Kaufman, and I met her. I saw her speak twice, and I met her a few months ago when she was out here in Scottsdale, Arizona. And she was talking about her protocols. So let me tell you a little bit more about her, but also just to let you know that she has agreed to talk about sex today on the show, which, of course, is my specialty. And I'm very excited to hear her take on various things that we could be doing for ourselves to enhance and increase our sex life and to make it better. So let me tell you about her. Dr. Sandra Kaufman is the chief of pediatric anesthesia at the Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital in Hollywood, Florida. She's the author of The Kaufman Protocol, Why We Age and How to Stop It. This protocol about how to fight aging deals with the seven tenets of aging through the Kaufman rating system and by choosing the appropriate protocol. I'm going to just tell everybody that this woman is no joke. Like, she has a way, she has a system. She also has an app, which I think is called the Kaufman Protocol. We're going to find out in a minute. But she has a way for you to, like, click in your own stuff and then come up with some solutions to slow down your aging and to possibly prevent yourself from aging. So without further ado, Sandra Kaufman, welcome to Sex and Happiness.
Thank you. It's so great to be here. I can contribute anything you want to know about how not to age. I may leave the sex to you. We'll see how this goes.
Okay, well, we'll see. That's great. Can I call you Sandy? Is it okay if I call you Sandy?
Of course, absolutely.
Great. Okay. So, well, first of all, I'm going to say when I met you, I was wowed. I have met, you know, many of the scientists in the field of super longevity, including Liz Parrish, Bill Andrews. I certainly know Bill Falloon, Aubrey de Grey, the top heavy-hitting people in the field, Brian Fahey, so on. And when you came and spoke, I was just wowed because you had a practical, you have a practical thing that people can actually use. You have like the slide rule of anti-aging. That's what I like to call it.
That's brilliant. I love that.
Yeah. It's like, you know, put in this, coordinate, you know, A with B with C with D and come up with what your formula is. And since I met you, I started eating collagen. Before that, I was only like probably rubbing collagen on my face. And I started also eating
hyaluronic acid.
Yeah, hyaluronic acid. I started eating hyaluronic acid, which I was rubbing on my lips and on mm-hmm. my little marks around my mouth. So I started taking that internally because you said, eat it. Just take it however you can. Take a lot of it. So I started, I changed my protocols accordingly based on things that you said. And you know, I don't
fabulous.
Know. If it's working. Yeah, I don't know if it's working yet, but I'm doing it for sure. So, how did you get to be who you are? You know, when you were a kid, did you know you wanted to be a doctor?
Oh gosh, no. I didn't know what I was going to be. You know, I'm the middle kid. My father's an endocrinologist. My mother was a musician. I was a pretty standard kid. My mother, however, became very ill when I was a teenager. And, you know, things always go through family. So her father was a diabetic and he lost both of his legs. And she was terrified of that. And then she was actually the first victim of toxic shock therapy. So when I was a teenager, she lost both of her legs and all of her fingers. And this was just earth-shattering to everyone while the family was going through a divorce. So there was a lot of sort of emotional shakeup. But I was terrified of losing my ability to function. So I probably, I mean, that's why I went into medicine ultimately. I sort of detoured as a plant and cellular physiologist, decided that cells don't pay bills, went to med school, was going to be a neurosurgeon, did that for a year, was going to be a general surgeon, did that for a year, and ended up being an anesthesiologist. And I think it's kind of fun because it's pharmacology, it's physiology, it's all sort of, it's all of the ologies put together, and I get to play with kids, so it's kind of a lot of fun. The question, of course, there is, how in the world did I get into longevity? And the answer is everything boils down to cells. Kids are cells, we're cells, everybody's cells, and cells don't do very well with time. And I decided when I was about 45 that I was going to figure it out, damn it. I know that there are a lot of experts out there, but nothing seemed to trickle down into the real world. Ooh. And all the gentlemen and ladies that you mentioned, they're brilliant. They really are brilliant.
Yes.
But I think that they live in, but I know a lot of them, and I think they just live in the clouds, such that I wanted to develop something that everyone could use, you know, mostly myself, because I'm a selfish human, but I wanted to figure out why things worked the way that they worked and what we could do on a practical scale until like the big therapies came through that these guys were developing.
Yes.
So that's sort of how I got there, but it was not an easy path.
But I imagine you were traumatized by this diabetes thing that happened with your mother and with her father or what have you. I mean, the people that you just described, it must have been super traumatic for them and then super traumatic for you as the kid, you know, to watch somebody losing pieces of their body.
Oh, it's horrible. And you know, I've been an athlete my whole life. I'm a rock climber. I scale mountains. I run. I bike. I do all of these things. And my mother lost all of her, you know, distal extremities when I was 15, and she was 42. And of course, when you're 15 and your mother's 42, she looks really old. And I thought, oh my God, 42, that's just horrific. What am I ever going to do? And what's ironic is now that I'm 50, it doesn't seem quite so old anymore. But I was just determined that whatever happened to the people before me wasn't going to happen to me.
Yeah. Well, you're also, I mean, you're 50 and you look stunning, gorgeous, fabulous. I know some of it you do, some of it, you know, is work that you do to yourself. And some of it is just who you are in fantastic shape. I mean, your arms are fabulous arms.
Well, thank you. Thank you. You can thank the art of rock climbing for that.
I was
but thank you.
Say, those look like rock climbers' arms. You know, you're in great shape, and I understand how family things like that could make you want to excel in being physical. You know, and I admire you for that. I too am an athlete, but I developed it later on. I mean, I was like a dancer when I was growing up. I don't consider that really a sport, and then I. Then I became an animal in the gym because I started getting into super longevity. And now, mm-hmm. I mean, I take injections of Somorlin. And so when I'm at the gym, I'm 71. And when I'm at the gym, I work out like an animal. I might as well be 15.
Isn't that amazing? I mean, we don't have to live by chronological age anymore. We live by physiologic age.
Yes.
And I'm hoping to erase the idea of age. I just want to walk in and be who we are and maximize our capacity and not have to think about what I'm doing as compared to my age.
Yes, I agree with you. Amen. I say aho to that. That's really good. So I love that you did this. I love what you became. I think it's amazing that you work with anesthesiology with children. And then, you know, in your spare time, whenever the hell that is, you write a book that coordinates the way people can start to take charge of their own life in terms of aging. That's like amazing. And you have another book coming out. You told me when we saw each other that you're, I don't know where you are in the stage of it, but you're writing a book about skin.
That is correct. I have innumerable projects at the moment because my life seems to have exploded outside of my real job. But yes, one of the things I'm working on right now is skin ages in slightly different ways than the rest of your body ages because it takes more damage from the outside world. And so I've decided rather than seven reasons that your body ages, your skin ages for like 9 or 10 reasons. I may reorganize them a bit. So that is where the second book is going to be aimed. And what I think is sort of interesting is a lot of people just look at their skin alone and say, well, that's aging or not aging. And it drives me nuts when you go to a clinic and they inject you with Botox and you say, ha ha, we've stopped you from aging. And the answer is, you haven't, right? You've paralyzed your muscle and you may look a little bit better. But the idea is real skin rejuvenation. What can you actually do to make your skin do better? Which is why I told you to take the collagen and the hyaluronic acid, because those are the building blocks of your skin. And if you're deficient, of course your skin's going to fall apart.
Yeah. So everyone,
that's the first easy step.
So everyone, did you hear that? Collagen and hyaluronic acid, you can apply them topically, but you can also eat them. You can put collagen in your shakes, which is what I do, and hyaluronic acid, I take it in a pill form. And, you know, it's not, so far nothing's happening that I have noticed, but if I can retard the aging process more than I already do, I'm all for it. So thank you, Dr. Sandra Kaufman, for more.
Oh, you're welcome. The caveat to that, let me just add one little thing,
yeah,
is vitamin C is a coenzyme in the production of collagen. So if you are not vitamin C replete, the collagen isn't going to do anything. So you may want to take a little bit of extra just to make sure.
I got it. So you have to have vitamin C as well. Wonderful. Thank you for
correct
that. I know I take vitamin C in some things, but I will resume taking extra vitamin C as well.
Fabulous. Perfect. Perfect.
So we
and
need
it's
to
not just for colds. People say it's for colds, but it's not for your skin. Anyway,
yeah.
I'm sorry. I digress
no,
frequently.
That's okay. Wonderful. So we're going to take a little break here. And when we come back, we're going to talk some more about the things that you can do to stop aging in your body. And we'll see if any of it relates to your sexuality. I'm hoping that it does. They already know what I have to say about sexuality, so I want to hear what you have to say about it.
Happy to.
So we'll see what we can come up with. If you just tuned in, you're listening to Sex and Happiness. I'm Laurie Handlers. Stay tuned. I am speaking to somebody. I'm going to call you one of the brilliant minds of our time. And
I love it.
Yes, that's who this woman is. She is no joke. She did the work, and she did it so that you, whoever you are out there, can listen and benefit. We'll be right back. Did you ever stop to think that love is your birthright? That you don't need to earn it or prove it? You just need to live it. I'm personally inviting you to the path of true love, power, and freedom. If you're ready to enliven your soul through conscious sexuality and dive deeply into profound ritual that frees your heart, I'm inviting you to join us for the spiritual sexual shamanic experience. This is better known to most of you as the ISTA Level 1 training. I am regularly leading these courses along with a team of accomplished facilitators all around the world. As a matter of fact, these trainings have taken place in 34 countries. For information on when I'm leading, go to butterflyworkshops.com. Or for a full schedule, you can go to schooloftemplearts.org. Please consider this invitation seriously, because love and freedom are your natural state of being.
Are you wondering what book to read to jumpstart your life, get the best from relationships, attain the deepest feelings of intimacy? Do you want the best sex along with great happiness? Get your copy of Sex and Happiness, The Tantric Laws of Intimacy by Laurie Handlers right now. You'll learn how to make love in the unknown, take the performance anxiety and reaching a goal out of sex. You'll learn subtle ways of communication and really important practices to empower you when dealing with an intimate partner. You'll let go of blame and struggle. Doesn't this sound great? Sex and Happiness puts the innocence back into sex and gives Tantra the respect it deserves. Take charge of your life, physically, emotionally, and spiritually with Sex and Happiness by Laurie Handlers, only $19.99 paperback and $14.99 ebook. Order your copy today by going to butterflyworkshops.com. That's butterflyworkshops.com. for your copy of Sex and Happiness.
My question for people right now is, if you're a woman who could use a little zest and zing in your arousal response or maybe you know women or a woman who could use this, because many women say that their feelings of desire, arousal, and sexual satisfaction don't happen as naturally or as often as they'd like. So I want to tell you about Zestra, because Zestra was developed to meet this much-needed option for women. Zestra is safe and a patented blend of botanical oils and extracts, and it's created to help women have increased sexual sensations. Zestra comes in convenient single-dose personal packets. Each packet keeps the essential arousal oils and extracts free, fresh, and safe from light. And with application of Zestra, it starts to work within 3 to 5 minutes. And at about 10 minutes, there's something called the Zestra Rush. And that can last up to about 45 minutes. The great news is that Zestra can be used as frequently as you like during each sexual experience. Now, I'm somebody who believes that all women deserve sexual satisfaction. That's why I do this show, in case you hadn't noticed. So I believe that men and women deserve sexual satisfaction. So if you're a woman who isn't getting that kind of arousal response that you want, please call 877-426-8047. That's 877-426-8047. And please remember to say you heard about Zestra from Laurie Handlers on the Sex and Happiness Show.
We are back with Sex and Happiness, and today I'm speaking with Dr. Sandra Kaufman. And as I said earlier, she's the chief of pediatric anesthesia at the Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital. That's what she does by day. And the rest of the time, by night, by weekend, by whatever, she is completely enthralled in the subject of anti-aging. And I call that super longevity. And so she's written this book, The Kaufman Protocol, and you can either get the app. By the way, what is the app? What's the name of the app?
It's very easy. It's the Kaufman Protocol.
The Kaufman Protocol. Okay, so you can get the app. You can plug yourself in by answering some of the questions or putting in your specific conditions that you want to work on, and then you do the coordinating, and you come up with some very not difficult to do things. What do we call strategies that you can use that will help you stop the aging process in your body? So, Sandy, let's talk some more about this. I took copious notes the last time I saw you. I remember you talked about metformin, which I already was taking. You talked about the collagen, the hyaluronic acid. And a couple of other things. You talked about cumin, I think.
And curcumin, yes.
Oh, curcumin, yeah. And then something else. You had like five really biggies. But we can go in general. What would help people in terms of their, let's talk about their men's testosterone loss or women's testosterone loss when they turn around 50. What should they do about that?
Well, I'm gonna back you up for a second.
All right.
And I want just to sort of give people a general. You had the either the painful experience or the educational experience of listening to me talk on and on and on. But for people that have never heard this before, the basic idea of my program is that you can take your own cells and make them work as optimally as possible. Okay, so what I have done is if you look at each of the seven categories of aging, each of the molecular agents that I talk about is rated in each of those categories. So what happens is in my world, I'm looking at a giant numerical grid. And so what I allow people to do is make their own programs based on which categories are more important to them. For example, if you wanted to take something that had more to do with diabetes, you would take something that had a higher score in the waste management category, because that's glucose management, versus someone that had inflammatory issues, they'd take something that had more in the security system in arena. So I now have rated 30 agents, and I go through them in depth, 15 of them in depth in the book, and there's 30 of them on the app. And I think I talk about, in my first lecture, I talk about two or three of them, and then in the second lecture, maybe five or six of them, to give people an idea of how to build their own program. So the question, therefore, is what do you do about sex hormones? Because that's what people want to know.
Yeah.
My theory is if you are premenopausal or reasonably young, I mean, it doesn't work for 70, 80-year-olds quite yet. If you can maximize the cellular health of those cells, you can have the same output as you had when you were 20 or 30. It does not have to drop off. For example, I have taken things that so I avoid menopause, which are not hormonal in any way. If you maintain the mitochondrial system of your cells, you don't go into menopause, at least I haven't yet, and all of my levels are as if I were 20 or 30. So I think that if you start this young enough, you don't have to worry about augmenting with any hormones.
Wow, that's amazing. I mean, I started menopause early, 42. Nobody wanted to talk about it then. My mother certainly didn't want to talk about it. Nobody wanted to talk about it. I felt like I was going to murder somebody if I had a gun. Like I just, mm-hmm. like I was mad all the time. The only thing available was Premarin, and I went for a prescription of it. I took one pill and I said, you know what? I don't want to take this. I'm not taking it. So I never took it. And then bioidentical hormones became popular, and I started taking those when I was 60.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been taking them for 11 years and I feel terrific. And, you know, I don't
want they are an absolutely great idea, because if you can't make your own anymore, it makes absolute sense to augment that. That's completely reasonable.
But
my issue at the moment.
Yeah. What you're saying.
If you start young enough, you can avoid the problem in the first place.
That is fantastic. That is so fantastic.
At least that's my goal. And, you know, this is all sort of, I've been at this now for 5 or 6 years, and I'm nowhere near to menopause, which is awesome. Probably a little too personal for listeners, but who cares?
No, not for my listeners.
But I don't know how long I can avoid it. And when I do eventually have hormonal shutdown, then of course I'm going to go to the bioidenticals, because that's just the reasonable thing to do. What was interesting, though, is there's a big push in men to augment testosterone at very young ages. And I think that's a because hormones work on a feedback loop, so that if your body gets extra and it perceives extra, it's going to stop making the endogenous amounts that it already makes.
Right.
So you're sort of shooting yourself in the foot at that point.
Yeah, I don't think.
So I think that men have to be very aware of that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't think men should do that. Just like men go out and they take recreational Viagra, and that's not good either, because then that starts to detract from their natural ability to get erect. And so by the time after they've taken between their 20s and 40s, they've taken a lot of recreational Viagra. By the time they're 45, that penis doesn't work as good anymore as it would have if they didn't do that.
You know what? That I'm going to leave that one to you, because I don't know about that.
I do know about that. And that, you know, they numb out too. So that's a difficult one. What about, we heard some doctor came and spoke to us and told men that they should sun their genitals, like they should get 20 minutes of sunshine every day on their bare genitals. Anything about that? Do you know anything about that one?
That sounds ridiculous. Why in the world would you do that? Oh, that's ridiculous. So vitamin D, number one, it's important to have some sun on your skin. On the other hand, sun, as far as I'm concerned, in terms of longevity, is the most horrific thing that can ever happen to your skin. Mm. So whereas sunning your genitals, that's ridiculous. Every woman, for the most part, is vitamin D deficient. And if you are, many bad things happen, including autoimmune diseases, and you have low ability to fight infection and a variety of other things. Most women should have their D levels checked, because we are all horrifically deficient. I'm not really sure how sunning a small part of your body is actually going to do anything to cure that. Mm. But that's an interesting suggestion if you're into nude sunbathing, I suppose.
Yeah, I mean, I get sun that way. I get some sun that way every day, about 20 minutes, nothing more. It doesn't make sense to stay in the sun much more. I come from, you know, earlier on in my life, that was the big thing, to go get tan and sit with sun reflectors and stuff like that. I mean, you know.
Oh, yes. I did that too.
I'm sure we're paying the price for that, but I do get some sun every day, a little bit of sun, at least when I'm home in Arizona. I'm on my way.
I will tell you, however,
is
you need to take, so vitamin, you need to block both the UVA and the UVB So a little bit of external sunblock is useful as well. You need the internal sunblocks that block the free radicals, which the best one is astaxanthin. And then polypodium actually helps repair the DNA damage from being out in the sun. So the combination of those things will allow you to get some sun for the vitamin D without getting a lot of DNA damage.
Hmm. That first one, astaxanthin, I started taking that.
Astaxanthin.
Yeah.
As oh, good.
You. Yeah. Yeah, you have had an influence on me. Oh, right, immediate.
That's fabulous. I'm thrilled. I'm glad I can be of assistance.
All right, let's talk a little bit more about some of the things that just really keeps people humming, like keeps them feeling good on the inside. What kind of things could they take to have them feel good on the inside? It's not just about how they look, but also really how they occur to themselves, spunky, energy, etc. What about that?
Okay. So most people that come to me, and what's interesting, as you said, I'm a pediatric anesthesiologist. My office is in the operating room. No one comes to see me as an anti-ager because I just don't have an office. However, the entire hospital at this point, they sneak into my office at some point and they ask me questions and what can I do about this and that. And the most frequent questions are, number one, I just don't have the energy I used to. And number two, I've got aches and pains. And when we get rid of those, people just seem to be more themselves. So whereas I push the idea that you have to not age in seven categories, those two are the big ones. Therefore, most people over the age of 40 are nicotinamide deficient. And nicotinamide, not the kind that you get from cigarettes or anything of that nature. Nicotinamide is important in your body for four reasons. And the biggest reason is because it is a rate-limiting step in energy production in the mitochondria. It sits in the electron transport chain. So if your transport chain doesn't work, you're not making ATP and you're tired. And unfortunately, as you age, you need more nicotinamide and you have less because you need it for four things. It's a cofactor for your sirtuins. It's the molecule is taken apart and used for DNA damage repairs, communication between your nucleus and your mitochondria. That's not important. The key is that you need it for energy production. So if you are deficient, you are just not making energy. And after 10 days, plus or minus, depending on how old you are, after being on it orally, people just feel better. And when they feel better, they're more like themselves, and then they're just happy. So that would be thing number one.
So say it again, nicotinamide.
So nicotinamide, yeah, it's an interesting molecule. There's only two molecules that you can, or two molecular agents that you can take right now. There's nicotinamide riboside and nicotinamide monoside, and they're both trademarked and copyrighted, or however that works for molecules, made by different companies. They're probably equivalent in terms of mode of action and all that. People are pushing for IV nicotinamide, which I think is a little bit unnecessary. I think it's a salesmanship thing. And you can also get patches, which I don't think is kind of silly. But however you decide to take your nicotinamide, it's going to make you feel better in about 10 days.
Mm, that's fabulous. And is it an expensive thing?
It depends how you define expensive.
Yeah. I had stem cells. That was $5,000. So it's less.
No. It's way less than that. Oh my goodness. So I buy them in bulk from Rev Genetics. What's funny is I have them in my office and I bought them in bulk for me. And now everyone sneaks into my office and takes bottles from me. So in bulk, they're about $20 for like 2 months supply or something.
Okay.
So it's not terrible. It's not terrible.
It's not expensive at all. Okay.
No.
So nicotinamide is one thing. And then you said there was something else about energy.
The second thing that people sort of complain about is mid 40s is aches and pains. They go to the gym, they try to be enthusiastic, and they just hurt. Or their back hurts. I mean, the lower back pain is the scourge of middle America. The best anti-inflammatory is curcumin. And people go, oh, yeah, I eat curcumin because I eat turmeric. And people are going to say, oh, it's turmeric. So there's this potato sort of thing. So people can just ignore my pronunciation if they decide to.
Okay.
but because everyone says, you're saying that wrong. I'm like, well, maybe you're saying that wrong. Anyway, whatever. Right. So if you eat turmeric, 1-3% of it is the curcumin. And curcumin itself is a fabulous molecule. But the bioavailability, meaning how much gets into your system and then how long it stays there, the half-life, are extremely terrible.
Mm.
So if you just take the straight stuff, it's about an hour. And so for the last 10, 15 years, companies have been trying to come up with different iterations to make it more bioavailable. And I think the top two at this point, there's one called DCM95, and then there's one called Metacurcumin. It doesn't really matter because they're both very efficacious. But one or two of those a day, and within a few days, your aches and pains are gone.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Now, keep in mind, both these agents do many other things that help you not age, but these are the things that people notice sort of up front.
Well, and so it isn't really a strained back or a pulled ligament or whatever that people just think they're doing. It's just sort of like aches and pains of aging, and this can help erase them.
Well, so what I tell people to take one a day, come hell or high water, one a day. And if you're hurting, take two. And that generally has gotten everyone over pain. And I will tell you that even people that like post-surgical pain, they don't want to take, you know, any of the narcotics. This actually works for that. And it is absolutely side effect free.
That is fantastic.
Although granted, I took four one day and I turned a little bit yellow. That was just me trying to see what would happen if I pushed the envelope. So
I would take CBD myself, but
sure. Yeah.
But I like this too. I like this. You know, for my work, I travel a lot. So being on an airplane, you travel a lot too. So being on an airplane makes you have aches and pains just because you were sitting in that freaking airplane for however long you were sitting on the airplane. And then you get up, there's nowhere really to stretch in a plane. So this is good to know. This is really, really good to know. Fabulous.
Yeah, and the other thing, just to sort of like round out the curcumin conversation, it is an epigenetic modifier, so it helps your DNA. It is a huge free radical scavenger, so it helps your mitochondria. It also, we talked about the immune system is amazing, and it's one of the few things that can actually reduce the accumulation of liposuction in your long-lived cells. And I don't know if that means anything to anyone.
No, I was
but
just going to say that.
Accumulate, it does to you. But no, so waste product in cells that are long-lived, like your brain cells, get clustered with garbage, cellular debris over the course of time. And if you look at an old person's brain cells, they're just filled with muck. You probably heard me refer to it as the kitchen drawer phenomenon.
Yes, there's too much stuff in there that you don't throw out.
Too much stuff. Right. And it just gets stuffed and more stuffed and more stuffed, and your brain can't function. So metacurcumin will actually get rid of some of the liposuction in your cells, which in my world is just a tremendous advantage.
It does
many things, but yeah. It's liquid gold as far as I'm concerned.
Metacurcumin sounds wonderful, really wonderful. Matter of fact, sounds like a good Christmas gift. It sounds like a gift.
It does actually, right?
That keeps on giving. It sounds like fantastic. And you just reminded me of something. I'm just going to say this because I was just at a workshop and someone brought two of these buffers, the kind you would use, like you would plug in and you would use it to buff the wax job on your car. And she was using it to massage people's bodies. She had a big one and a small one. And I went, oh my God. And she just buffed me. I felt like I was in a car wash, and when I stood up, you know, everything felt good, and I thought to myself, wow. And you know, they sell them at Home Depot. They're just like car buffers. So I'm giving that out. Like when you have the aches and pains, take curcumin and buff yourself. You know,
the question, however, is do you wax at the end?
No. It doesn't even require you to take your clothes off. You can get buffed with everything on
That doesn't sound like as much fun.
No, it was great. It's great. It's great. I don't know. I didn't get buffed with my clothes off. I'll have to see what that feels like.
Anyway, I think you should try it and report back.
We're going to take a short break here. When we come back, we're going to find out how they can get all the information from you, how they can, you know, download what they have to, go over the names of everything, and we'll see if we have any last minute tips for people, because I feel like you're giving tips here left and right. Hopefully a word to the wise, everyone is taking notes, or they will listen again so that they can get these things and make note of it. We will be right back with Sex and Happiness. I'm Laurie Handlers. I'm interviewing Dr. Sandra Kaufman. We're coming back.
So many times you've heard Laurie talk about emotional release on this show. She says over and over again how important it is for you and your loved ones. Now you can do emotional release in the privacy of your own home. And you can practice Lottie Hahn too, meditation that prepares you for making love in the unknown. In her CD, Shamanic Release and Lottie Hahn, she creates a safe and sacred space in which you can do the powerful work Laurie is known for in her Butterfly Workshops courses. Laurie sets you up with the proper positioning and breathing. Then she guides you through each emotional state to the beat of tribal African rhythms. This CD actually provides an easy way to do emotional clearing work on a regular basis. Order your copy of Shamanic Release and Lottie Hahn today and watch your relationships walk free of emotional baggage. To order your copy, go to butterflyworkshops.com right now.
As a sex and happiness coach, I understand that increased sexual participation intensifies sexual responsiveness and desire, as well as overall health and well-being. My experience with a Sibian has personally increased my sexual response, and I can now train women to use this machine to have peak orgasms as often as possible. I strongly believe this will add to their health and well-being, whether they have a partner or not. The beauty and the miracle of the human body is that it adapts and changes much more rapidly than people change their beliefs or their opinions. The Sibian can make any woman's body more resilient with each peak orgasm. Sibian is an amazing experience, often described as the Lamborghini of sex toys. If you're a woman and you can get yourself to look at Sibian, you should do so. It won't take away from your partner. It will only add. Trust me on this. I love my Sibian. Go to Sibian.com. That's Sibian.com. Or call 1-800-253-6135. That's 800-253-6135, and say Laurie Handlers told you about Sibian. And by the way, if you do have a partner, ask about Venus for Men. That's Venus, V-E-N-U-S, for Men. We are back with Sex and Happiness. You know, I want to ask you this question. Like, if you suddenly woke up, or if somebody suddenly wakes up and they don't have any sex drive, and they're not sure yet about the hormones or whatever, is there any particular thing that you might, like in the old days when I was first studying Tantra, people used to say to take a plant called Yohimbe. Do you know anything about mm-hmm. that? Or are there anything, any of your things that you've come across have to do with sex drive?
There have been, but you know, it's interesting. So in preparation for talking to you, I tried to take a deep dive into real scientific literature so I could sound like I knew something about sex and longevity. And what's really interesting is studies have actually shown that men never lose their sex drive. Up until the day they die, their thoughts about sex and their desire are exactly the same. So it's not really an issue with men. Despite maybe their physical inability to do whatever it is they want to do.
Right.
In women, it has less to do with hormone and physiologic ability than it does with emotion.
Mm.
So studies, at least the ones that I was reading, saying if they're comfortable with their bodies, if they are comfortable with their partner and they're happy and they're healthy and they're exercising, that it doesn't matter what else is going on in their lives, they remain sexually happy. So I don't necessarily think that you need a chemical to help you. I think, just as you know, according to these studies, that it's more emotional.
That's amazing. I mean, it's not. I'm not like totally surprised, but I just think it's interesting between the genders, the difference. You know, Bill Andrews gave me a study once that I spoke about at Radfest, the Radfest before you came, the one before that. And he said they studied 129 couples. I don't know why that number, but 129 couples. Of those, there was a control group, and then there was a group that had sex about five times a week. And in the couples that had sex five times a week, they measured the telomeres of the women. Well, they measured all the women's telomeres in this study. And the women's telomeres that had regular sex, they didn't talk about good or emotionally gratifying sex or anything like that. They just said that the women who had regular sex, like at least 4 to 5 times a week, had longer telomeres than the women who didn't. That was the first sex study that he said that was published in PubMed that he could find.
Well, you know, it's interesting. I spent the last many weeks looking for this stuff, and I've decided that's the chicken and egg phenomenon, right? Are you healthier and you're happier and you're more vigorous and therefore you have more sex, or you have more sex and therefore you're healthier and you're happier? For example, there's a study out of Wales. They looked at a cluster of men. I forget how many. It's retrospective over the course of 10 years. And they decided that if you had regular orgasms, your risk of coronary disease went down by 50%. Actually, mortality by coronary disease dropped 50%. So the question is are you vigorous enough to have all of these orgasms such that you're not going to die of coronary disease? Or is it the other way around? Right?
Yes.
It's really hard to say. And to answer the telomere question, anything that promotes or decreases stress can increase telomere length. Yoga has been demonstrated to increase telomere length. There are a lot of very positive things that can do it. So I have no doubt that sex can do it. Mm-hmm. Because it's a positive thing. People release very good vibes. And how does that, you know, correlate to concentrations of hormones? I'm sure it does. I don't really know specifically.
Yeah.
But things that make you feel better obviously increase your telomere length. And the converse is true as well. But it does become the chicken and the egg phenomenon.
Yeah, because you can't tell which came first. Is it that you're vital?
No.
That you're vital and so you want to have sex, or is it that you have sex and then you become more vital? I like to think that they go hand in hand. When people tell me that they're super happy and they also then tell me that they're not having sex, I'm like very skeptical. I just can't.
Well, it's very partner dependent as well.
Yes. Yes, it could be. It could be. Although in my presentation at Radfest, I told people that their hands work and that they should be having sex anyway on the way to having a new partner. So,
but you know what's very interesting? This only works for mammals. Did you know this? And you probably knew this. For bugs, if you have sex, you are diminishing your lifespan.
Right. Like the praying mantis.
Well, yeah, having your head eaten off is probably not good for longevity. No, but for example, like in the stink bug population, just because this is moderately random, if you are a virgin stink bug female, your life is doubled. If you are a virgin stink bug male, your lifespan is 6 times the length of a non-virginal stink bug.
Wow.
Because the metabolic price of copulation and egg laying and all of those things is exorbitant.
Yes.
So for every bug that I could find, it's really bad for you. So it's more of a species system versus an individual. Why would you want to do that? That's nuts, right?
I'm glad I'm a human.
Up until you get to, no kidding. Well, you know, naked mole rats actually have it really well, just to put that out there. So in the naked mole rat population that are known for their longevity, there's two types of women. There's the breeding women and the non-breeding worker women. And the breeding women that have the babies, obviously, live twice as long.
Wow.
Right? Isn't that interesting? And I don't know if it has to do they have, you know, more people helping them, less bitter lives? Do they have better nutrition? I have no idea.
Yeah.
But clearly, if you are a naked mole rat, it is better to be a breeder.
Well, I think, you know, my show is really for humans. So I think sex and happiness go hand in hand, but it sounds like in some species that may be true too. I mean, I like studying, I like reading and talking about bonobos. They settle everything.
Oh, yes.
Sex. They're wonderful.
Oh, I love bonobos.
Yeah. So it's all good. Let's let people know how they can find your work. So the Kaufman Protocol, is that on Amazon?
That is correct. It is very easy because everything has exactly the same name because I'm not that creative. I'm more of a science geek. So there's a website. It's KaufmanProtocol.com, and it talks about everything one needs to know, sort of a mini version. So it goes through the tenets, and it goes through how the numbering system works and how you can make your own protocol and that sort of thing. And then there's a page that has links and dosages if people want to go buy the products. I make not a dime off of that, so I'm not trying to sell anything to anyone. I'm just trying to give people information and vet appropriate vendors. The book is the heart of the matter. It tells you everything you want to know, probably in too much vivid detail. I tried to write it such that it's humorous and yet scientific at the same time, so hopefully people will enjoy that, and that is on Amazon. And okay. Then what? So it's easy. It's an ebook and it's a regular book. Usually people bring the book back to me with folded pages and things are underlined and highlighters everywhere. And they have their little note cards with thousands of questions. And I love those people. I just find that so intriguing. When I wrote this, I had no idea that anyone would ever read it, let alone study it. So I'm so excited about that.
It's great. It's a huge contribution. It is a huge contribution. And you are funny. So I'm just telling everyone, if you're getting the book and she says she tried to be funny, she is funny.
Well, I hope people find it funny. I hope that you've looked at it a little bit. The prose that runs through the whole thing is written so in the medium-ish of science world so that pretty much anyone can understand it. Mm-hmm. And then sections and italics are meant for people who want like more nuggets of scientific information. And then there's running sarcasm in the corners. So something for everybody, hopefully.
That's great. All right. Wonderful. And then they can download the app, the Kaufman Protocol.
So the point of the app, let me back up just one sec. The point of the app was people, I tried to give them all of the information to make their own personalized protocol. And it's hard. It really is hard. So the point of the app was so that people could put in their information, press the button, and then following an algorithm that I wrote tells them what to do so that they don't have to worry about it. No guessing games.
That's what's beautiful about it. I just wanted to point out that the name Kaufman is with a K. So some people would spell it with a C, but this is a K. So it's Sandra, S-A-N-D-R-A, or Sandra. Kaufman, K-A-U-F-M-A-N, Kaufman Protocol.
So close. I have two N's.
Kaufman, K-A-U-F-M-A-N-N, Protocol.
Check.
So you can find it. That's how you find it. That's how you find her. And do it. Like, just do it. I mean, unless you're, you know, aging and happy that you're aging, I can't imagine that. I don't know anyone who is, but, and even when they tell me they are, I look at them like, yeah, right, sure. Whatever. you bought into the cultural narrative, you know, like, whatever.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Well, you know what I tell people, just really briefly, because I think this is important. People say, why would I want to live forever? And the answer is you don't, but you want to live as well as you can, as long as you can. So we talk about health span as well as lifespan. I don't want to like be traked in a wheelchair drooling for 100 years. I want to be out living my life, doing what I enjoy doing, being with family and people that I love as long as possible. And that's pretty much, how could anyone argue with that?
I certainly can't. So thank you for that. And thank you for your contribution to this. You've made it. You've made it less geeky. You as a geek have made it less geeky for others, for people like myself to be able to just look stuff up and go, yeah, I can do this. Let's do it. Wonderful. Thank you so much for being my guest today and for doing what you do in the world. And I know we're going to cross paths again and I'm looking forward to it.
Well, so nice talking to you. I really appreciate it. This is fun.
Thank you. And skin, we'll get to it when you do the skin part as well. I can't wait for that. So thank you. Really, really thank you. Everybody else, thank you for being my guests. I mean, my listeners, I wouldn't do this show without you listening in. Next time, I have an amazing guest. Some of you may have heard of her. Her name is Alison Armstrong. She has a website called Understand Men, and she has programs on understanding men and understanding women, and she has a lot to say about it because a lot of times we don't understand each other. She has simple things that make us laugh at ourselves and make us understand that the other gender might not be as much like us as we think. So that's what my next show is going to be about. Please tune into Sex and Happiness then. This is Laurie Handler signing off for Sex and Happiness. Again, thank you. Much gratitude.
Thank you for joining us today for Sex and Happiness. To learn more about Laurie and her work, please go to butterflyworkshops.com or follow her on Twitter or Facebook. You can send her an email at sexandhappiness@gmail.com. We'll see you again right here next week for another edition of Sex and Happiness. Oh.